Woo woo!
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
Hold on.
In my heart, I have but one desire. And
hey.
That one is you.
Thank you, Nitro.
No other will do.
I just saw it in Pandora's chat.
I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want.
Okay, it's enough with that. Okay. So, all aboard. Gameplay. Oh, we're discussing this is very easy. Do I miss a notification? Thanks, Wario. You're late, you piece of garbage. This is gonna be a casual playthrough. Brightness is fine. Auto basic is fine. HUD color, Pip-Boy color. HUD color, we're gonna make white. Pip-Boy can be blue, I suppose. Subtitles on. Saving automatically because it's a good game like that. I could get the DLC later. New game! So welcome everyone from my Twitch and my YouTube channel. It is currently 10:48 at night. I know some of you are like, oh, you have work tomorrow. I work night shift, so I'm probably going to sleep during the day. I'm also going to, you know,
set the world
get a good amount of sleep, because all I really have to do tomorrow is upload a video, and then tomorrow I'll mess around with some stream stuff.
A flame in your heart. In my
I'm gonna share my stream.
I have but one. And
I forgot how interesting the music choice is for this game because it's like a post-apocalyptic.
No other will do.
It's been forever since I played Fallout 3 specifically, because Fallout 3
I've lost
is my
all
favorite
ambition
Fallout.
For worldly acclaim, I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of being complete.
All aboard the hype train! We're gonna be playing a good chunk of this. I'm gonna share this on Twitter. And then we're gonna get into the game. Look at that guy! Bethesda Studios presents one of the best games ever, and the game I got my family addicted to. So basically, I had a PS2, not PS2, a PS3, my own room for
war.
A while back.
War never changes.
Shut up.
Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors
and,
first discovered the killing power,
I would play this,
and bone.
When I wasn't doing something else. I saw it. It looked
blood has been spilled in the name of everything, from God to justice.
And honestly, I enjoyed this game. My sisters were like, hey, what you're playing? I'm playing this. They thought it looked cool. And there were times that literally my sisters would just take my room for the whole
after
day.
After millennia of armed conflict,
and literally just
the destructive
Fallout
nature
3.
Of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation.
This is. I played the other Fallout games as well.
As some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead,
like I've played New Vegas, I played 4.
Was simply the prologue.
I played
to
some
another
other ones
bloody
too.
Chapter of human
Maybe
history.
I played a weird Fallout Shelter.
For man had succeeded in destroying the world.
But this is by far my favorite.
But war.
I know a lot of people say New Vegas is their favorite, but I like this better than New Vegas. I even thought 4 was better than New Vegas. Sue me.
In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge
thousands
in enormous
spared.
Underground
Yet
shelters.
Here we are fucking today.
But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them.
Everyone's asleep.
All except those in Vault 101.
But me, because I know we stay up to 1 because of my nephew.
For on that fateful day, when fire rained.
For on that fateful day, we're shutting up now and getting into the game. I was bored.
Let's see, are you a boy or a girl?
Well, let me check my parts. I'm a boy.
It's a boy.
All I did was just move my shirt.
A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. A beautiful son.
I am the opposite of beautiful. What are you talking about?
I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother.
Right. I have to come up with an original name. I'm not going to use my real name. Actually, I will.
That's Sean. A good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished
Yay.
The gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
Okay. Warning, this is not actually what I look like. Because that would be stupid. So I will be male. And I'm gonna go Caucasian, I suppose. I'm gonna make it like me, but not completely like me. Okay. How pale can we make you? Very pale. I wonder if I can get rid of those lines like right by my nose. Only 4 eye colors. Weak. Blue. I forgot about that bad part. Hair. Of course I'm going to give myself facial hair, because I look beautiful with it. No. Nope. Let's see, what is the most... separately completely. I could rock with that. But I want to say there's anything else. I like how there's one just called Daddy-O. I don't know why that's the same. Tough guy. Sideburns. Look at me! I'm a gunslinger. Dead Redemption. Goatee not bad. That ain't bad. Fireless beard. Let's go with the rough beard. Here, stop. I figure I'm going to be wearing a hat most of the time, so it'll be a rarity to see my hair. Sure, the Warhawk. Oh god, what color do we want it to be? Was there any good ones? No. Interesting. I can be more weird than that. Mwah! I'm beautiful. Okay, I still want to change something about the face. Something about it. Okay, don't mess with that setting. Also, don't mess with that setting. Brown, maybe? This is always the favorite part about RPGs. You literally make your own person. I don't know. This'll do. I might have to change it into preset. No, I cannot. Those lines are there to stay. So, despite me thinking that that would work, it was the exact opposite. Son of a bitch. Well, let's just start all over again. From the top, let me make myself very pale. Blue eyes, that works. Warhawk and Roughbeard. Facial hair. Roughbeard. Beautiful. And now for everyone's favorite hair color. Well, not everyone's favorite hair color, but the one I'm going to rock with because I'm different. Not red. Beautiful. And done. I look distinguished.
A lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh.
You see that? How I'm going to look like my father? Who's voiced by Liam Neeson?
It's a big world out there, son. Full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're just
James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. James. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Captain. Hang on.
Okay?
My mother's dead.
We need a
that
doctor,
sucks.
Not a dead baby.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations
no.
And there will be...
1 year later.
James and his cheery chatter.
Decorations look straight into the lighthouse. This place will feel nice. Just like home. It's just something you get used to down here. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to daddy.
Wow, okay. I'm a baby.
Come to daddy. You can make
it. Hey, dad.
There you go. My goodness. Just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo.
Hooray.
I know you don't like it when daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
Mama.
Yay. I have a ball. This ball belongs to me and no one else. Although I should probably put it in my toy box. Oh. Give me the ball. No, I'm being a good boy. I'm putting my ball back in my pen. There we go. Read the special book.
Dada.
You're special. S is for strength, and that means I am strong. I can carry more toys and swing stuff all day long. I'm just reading the book before I assign my skill points. P is for perception. A long, funny word. It means what I tasted, smelled, saw, and heard. E is for endurance. That's how long I can play. I'm always really healthy and have energy all day. C is for charisma. It's the way people think. I'm great. I make my friends all laugh and smile and never want to hate. I is for intelligence. It means I'm really smart. I use my brain for lots of stuff like science, math, and art. A is for agility. That's how I get around. I move real fast and easy, and I never make a sound. L is for luck, and it's simple. You see? It means that good things always happen to me. 1 point to luck. 1 point to intelligence. Actually, yeah, 1 point to intelligence. 2 to charisma. And 1 to strength. Oh, there we go. Perfect. All done. Now watch this. That's going to have no idea that I left the playpen. I didn't do anything.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you?
Oh, wait. Right, I just realized. The ball in the box gave me away. Me trying to be a good boy caught me caught.
See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21.
Yay, 6. Bible quotes. Not really.
I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved
I wonder
that.
What that actually means.
All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
Yay, Amada! It's our friend!
These experiments
don't
are
be a damn fool. We experiment.
9 years later.
We prepare to survive. Of course I miss her.
Surprise! Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday! Yay, birthday!
He is growing up so fast.
Happy
Yay.
Birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101...
Would you at least look at me when you're talking to me?
You're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are. As Overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be
Yay.
Getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once. So
I got an achievement.
Fun.
And look at that.
Happy birthday. We really surprised you, didn't we?
I would be
Your
more surprised if my dad got
us.
Out of the way.
But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
Great party. Thanks for doing this for
You're
me.
You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations
Yay.
And stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess.
I have no idea.
I knew I surprised you.
I'm
Who's your
acting.
Favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak, issue 14, and with no missing pages. I found this
I
in a box
book.
Of my father's old things, believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Oh,
Yay.
Man, you got a Pip-Boy.
I'll read the book right now. Wow, melee weapons increased by 1. I don't
I
think I'm going to need that
10.
Skill.
Hey,
what's up, Paul?
Thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that
no problem.
Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway,
nah.
happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What, are you two best friends now? Hey, Wally!
Happy birthday, Sonny.
Has gone soft on us.
Yeah, Paul.
Thank you.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amara put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason.
I don't know why.
I do not allow the fact that Amata is my daughter to come my position as overseer. I gave
sure.
her all the appropriate paternal encouragement, of course, but I could not contribute extra vault resources. That
okay.
is simply what my position requires. No more, no less. I know Amata understands that perfectly well.
Why don't you introduce
okay.
us to your new best friend?
Are you having a nice party?
Hi, Miss Palmer.
10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Such a nice, polite young man you are. Don't ever lose your gift to speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. You're the birthday boy. No sharing required today.
Yay, I'm going to eat this right away because I feel like it. And we're going to go talk to everyone's favorite mechanic.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything?
Yep.
As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability.
Reliability is good. Thank you, Stanley.
Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday. Not much, but I hope you like it.
Okay,
dork face.
Andy, wait!
I don't have my hawk yet. What did that robot do?
How's it going, pal?
Oh, there goes the cake. Oh, well.
Oh, no.
Hey, happy birthday, Nosebleed.
It's okay.
I'm mortified about the cake mishap. Simply mortified.
It's okay, Andy. It's not your
nice
fault.
Party.
Allow me to wish you a happy birthday.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that
it was
sweet
an accident.
Roll you got from Old Lady Palmer.
I ate it already.
What? Dang, I love those sweet rolls Old Lady Palmer makes. You little... Just stay out of my way, you got it?
Do not to ask
so,
all
what do you think we should call our guest?
I know you were joking, totally but I'm not sure anyone else...
He's a jerk.
Happy birthday, Sonny.
People always enjoy
my... Who wants
my
to go around all day being called a...
Besides, that friend of yours...
You really
having a good time? It wasn't easy keeping this kinda a secret.
Kinda. Butch is being an ass.
Sure else
it's supposed
like
to be a party, you know? Fun? You should
maybe
try it sometime, Daddy. You might
you guys like that?
Are you having a nice
happy...
What'd Butch want? I thought you were in trouble there for a second.
I'll live. A jerk tried to steal my sweet
God,
roll.
God, he really is a butthead. Oh, well.
No
you
shit.
Can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
Birthday, yeah, Sonny.
Ha.
Well, I
happy birthday, Sonny.
Think about it. Come on, Wally.
Do you think
these guys
have
good
ideas? I'm sure of it, Amato.
Yeah.
Plenty enough for Saturday's baseball game in the atrium.
Go on.
Super
and
cool,
yourself.
Right?
If anyone wants a tarot card reading, know where to find me. Enter the annual Vault 101 Bake Off. Lost one copy of Dean's electronics. If found, please return to Stanley.
I help with the decorations, you know.
Oh, really? They're lovely.
You
did such a splendid job.
A nice
Jonas?
Time.
Happy birthday.
A nice party.
Yay.
Now you let me know if that Pip-Boy ever gives you any trouble.
What do you guys
glad
think?
You could make it.
Okay.
You and your snakes and rats.
I think it's important
wizard
to keep
I can make lights.
People, you know,
shut up and let me
part
think
of my
of
job.
It.
Plus, well.
Hey, that was Jonas
up,
on
Dad?
The intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor.
I'm trying to show off as
go
much
ahead.
Of this game as I can.
I don't think
way.
Anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Okay.
Just because I
sure thing,
party,
Officer Gomez. Well, it's been nice chatting with you. Thanks.
Happy birthday, Beatrice. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did.
They had a great
my,
party.
My, 10 years old already? Why, I can
yeah.
remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since
yay.
This was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote
what?
You a poem just for you. I hope you
a
like
poem?
It.
It's too bad my grammar sucks.
Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
And for coming.
Why don't we read the poem? Because I feel like it. PA system. Gray walls, impenetrable steel. Suffocation, condemnation. Little hands groping in the sovereign uncertainty. I'm getting a little lost here, excuse me. Mommy, daddy, am I dead? Nay, nay, reborn into purifying fluorescence. A face emerges strong and male. Follow to me, follow to all. Overseeing our lives, our eternities. harshness of discipline, harshness of love, obedience my savior. Larva to pupa, pupa to worker, buzz, buzz. One with a steel honeycomb. 10 lives with the 101. Significant at last, till gray seeps from walls to hair to soul. Then eternal slumber, the sweet sleep of incineration. I'm pretty sure that went to disturbing very fast. Look at me in my hat. Ah, hi, Jonas.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level.
I'm not a kid, I'm 10 years old.
You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise. Your dad is waiting to give you your present. Or should we just keep it?
That's up to you guys. Hey, Adore.
Are you ready for your surprise? The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work. So, I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try?
We can't shoot it here.
We sure can't, unless we want the Overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on.
Can I close the door? Look at this. It's a BB gun.
Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want.
So it's a secret part. This is great. Thanks, Dad.
Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help.
I'll go thank him right now.
Happy birthday, buddy. I hope you have fun with it. Hey, you
Thanks
don't
a lot.
Turn
this
10
cool.
every day. Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
Shoot something? Okay. Let's go shoot stuff. Fire your weapon. Basic shooter controls. But it has to be close. You're going to listen to the best range.
It's a rad roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just aim and shoot. You'll be fine.
Okay. I killed it!
Good work. That's one less rad roach to deal
with. First kill.
Let's get a picture together. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with the big game hunter.
I actually want to see if this is possible.
Hey,
over here, son.
Shoot at the targets, okay? They're not a toy.
Over here, son.
Careful with that, sport. Ow!
I'm just seeing if this is possible. I doubt it. How'd I miss? I got him. This is so much fun target practice. I'm very good at this.
Careful with that, sport. Ow! Ow! Whoa, that stinks.
There's something about him going ow all the time. It's kind of funny. Jonas took a nap. He took a picture while he was asleep.
I'm the Overseer's daughter, so what? Like, I get
6 years later, I'm 16, and I'm starting the mall today.
I am Alpha and Omega.
Hang down, I'm on my own for the first time. Da-dun-dun-da-dun.
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now.
Oh, bobblehead.
You've got a goat to take. A generalized occupational aptitude test. GOAT. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have
kind
here
of
in Vault 101.
Answer a bunch of random questions.
So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar?
Yeah.
Hey, it's not my call. You're 16. Come on. It's not so. Take care, son.
Bye, Dad.
Now get out of here, and good luck.
Mine. Medicine skills apparently increased by 10 points. Yay! Let's read some computer stuff. Patient files. Freddy Gomez. Freddy's EDS is getting worse most days. He can't even get out of bed. When he does manage to function, Freddy hides his insecurities and low self-esteem behind a bully's mask. Ouch. Vault-Tec medical protocols decide the prescription of an anti-anxiety medication when vault-depressive syndrome is involved. But do I really want to string a kid on chlorpromazine for the rest of his life? Probably. Stanley continues to suffer from severe and chronic head pain. I've been feeding him aspirin like it's candy, but I'm reticent to give him anything stronger. He blames the lighting in his quarters, and though eye strain is certainly compounding the problem, the headaches are likely a symptom of overwork and lack of sleep. Then we Stanley end the schedule the overseer has him on. The problem isn't likely to get any better in time soon, so it's aspirin indefinitely. Motto. Once again, the overseer has insisted on being in the room for a mock examination, throwing any inkling of our doctor patient confidentiality right out the window. I know he doesn't trust me. He never has. But honestly, the reason he attends his daughter's medical appointment is because he doesn't trust her. That, as ridiculous as it is, sad. Amada is a great girl, and the chance of her doing something stupid, pregnancy, syphilis, whatever, is so unlikely, it's not even worth mentioning. Wait, experiments? Experiment 27CE. The cells are still replicating normally. No mutation, thank God. If whatever is out there could penetrate the vault, I can't even begin to imagine what the overseer would do. After borrowing a few more water chips and rerouting some of the power here in the clinic, I finally been able to affect the latest sample. It's not much, but considering what I have to work with it, a definite step in the right direction. But this new experiment was also monumental for another reason. It's the first time Jonas has assisted me. He suspected forever. I know, so I guess it's been inevitable. And itself has been invaluable. I just hope he knows what he's gotten himself into. A lot of shit. This is locked? I was just looking at that.
Good morning.
Hi, Jonas.
Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh?
Yep. I'm staying on my way.
Good
What's
to
up,
see
Brad?
You.
Stanley?
I'm a little
How you doing?
Worried. I hope Jonas can take a look at me soon. Over these results?
I'm sure he will. Lockers! Empty!
Worried about?
I just huh? like to keep an eye on.
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amada.
God, Butch! Why don't you just leave me alone?
What are you gonna do, Amada? Yeah? What do you want?
What's going on here?
None of your... If you...
The overseer's gonna come down on
Maybe
your gang,
right.
Butch.
We can deal with her later. Come on, tunnel
so
snakes.
Shut up before I knock you the fuck out. Time.
Whatever you say, Butch. You're the boss. Tunnel snakes rule.
Fine. Let's go.
Weirdos, am I right?
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know
You're
why
welcome.
They won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Hi, Stanley.
I know, right? Let's get to class. I wonder if I have my hat still. Nope! That's kind of lame.
Even with the pills you gave me last week?
Hey,
let's take a
well,
test.
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust
yep.
me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through.
Like high school.
I'm sure you will. Especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck.
Get out of my face.
Back off.
I'll sit up front, I suppose.
Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves.
I'm close to Mr. Brotch's.
Yes,
Brotch's.
I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question.
All right.
A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response?
The third one.
Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do?
Amputate, I suppose? No, oh, medicate it.
You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do?
How do we know if it's stolen?
Question four.
Give him a hug, I suppose.
Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer?
Pitcher.
Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another Vault resident. What do you do?
Number three is the funny one.
Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question seven.
Bobby pins!
Oh no. You've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment?
Precision laser!
A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number one. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it?
Trade.
Question nine. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and...
Leave a giant fart. No, I wish. Firecracker plus toilet.
Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives.
Mr. Brotch. No.
Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
I'm just going to tell mine straight away, and then we're going to hear what the others had to say. And then we'll go catch up with Amada.
All finished?
Hi, Mr. Brotch.
It says
yes,
here
sir?
You're perfectly suited for a career as a waste management specialist. A specialist, mind you, not just a dabbler. Congratulations.
Not bad.
Yes, it's refreshing to see such youthful enthusiasm.
That'll affect my skills,
good
actually.
To know that the goat occasionally gets it right. You know what they say about monkeys and typewriters. Well, I'm glad things turned out so well for you. I hope your classmates find their results half as satisfying.
Explosion, medicine, speech. Why explosives? Not that. I'm gonna keep medicine at what it is. Small guns. And we will also do repair.
Here you are, Mr. Brush.
All right, Amada.
I did okay.
Nothing.
You're fine.
About Miss Almodovar. Let's see. Very well done. Looks like it's the supervisory track for you.
Thanks.
Amada's my boss.
Yo, teach.
Thank God that's over.
Butch.
Come on.
How about
let's
we just go for Amada? That's a great idea. I'm a specialist. Three years later.
Selfish and insubordinate.
You need wake up. To know this. Come on, wake up.
I'm not going to be around to hold you down forever.
It's another shift day already.
You've got to wake up. You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you.
What do you mean he's gone?
He's left the vault. I don't know how, but he's gone. And my father, he's kind of gone crazy.
Great.
It's Jonas. They killed him. My father's men. They took him and... Oh my God, you have to leave now. Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas was your friend. But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute. I'm sorry, but I think you'll have to follow your dad. You'll have to escape from the vault. Listen, maybe it isn't any of my business, but didn't your dad tell you that he was leaving?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan.
Yay!
Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in.
All right.
Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case.
Thanks, Amada.
Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck!
Alright, let's arm up and get out of here.
I'll meet you at the vault door.
BB gun.
But don't wait for me.
Check. BBs. Medics and stim pack. Baseball bat. Glove and baseball can stay. This'll work. Give me one of these. Actually, I'll take one of these in case my mind gets busted. Okay. I think I got everything we need. Actually, we can probably leave the hat off until we get out of this vault. Assuming we get out of this vault alive. Nothing in that dresser. God damn it, Dad.
There he is. Hold it right there. Criminy, more roaches.
I think I missed all those shots. Fuck you, Roach. Officer Kendall, I'm afraid I'm gonna need your armor. And your helmet. And also, fuck you. For trying to murder me. Alright, let's keep going. I missed. Grandma Taylor, no! You are my favorite. Who are you? Oh my days, I forget how fun this game is. and how great the bat system is.
Where do they keep coming from? There's more. Over here.
A little piece of fire to the last.
Ah, young sir. How very good to see you again. I do see
that. You're the one everybody's looking for, right? Well, it's none of my business. Your dad always took good care of us.
I'm afraid you've missed him. I believe
me and Andy were in a tight spot there. Ain't no mistake. Good thing he loves tasting roaches so much. Just hold still. You're left stabilized. Oh, you're lucky it was me who found you. The others
won't
be so forgiving.
What's up, Officer Gomez?
I don't know what you're up to, right. I don't want to know. Just clear out of here, and I'll pretend I never saw you.
Thanks, Officer Gomez.
It's a real shame it's come to this. I can't believe what they did to Jonas. Officer Mack was just out of control. But you're a good kid. You didn't do anything to deserve this. Go find your dad, if you can. He's been knocked
loose. Okay.
I am holding still. It's your old...
Okay, is there anything I miss here? Locker? No. I don't have enough lockpick for that. Because you need 50 lockpick to open average ones.
What the hell has gotten into the overseer? If you keep turning like that, I'm gonna crack your casing.
Don't blame me.
Alright, let's get to the atrium and let's get out of here. The whole world's gone mad, everybody.
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here, just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us.
The Holdens, what's up?
It's me, Tom Holden.
Be careful.
Here we go.
Oh! Oh! You killed an innocent man, you bastards!
Not interfere. Any resident found outside his or her quarters will be dealt with.
Get out of here. Tom, you're an idiot. All this stuff. Richards and O'Brien, man, they're just crazy. I tell you. Actually, I'm gonna keep the utility fast. There we go. So Mary Holden probably escaped. I got a good ton of bullets left. Let's keep going. Stupid roach. Oh, you were actually alive. And now you have no head. You gotta love the bat system in this game.
You and your stupid father. He had to go and leave, didn't he? He had to mess things up for everybody.
I'll shoot you if I see you again.
The doc's stupid kid is over here. He's trying to leave the ball.
Target down. I think I missed.
Whatever, I've got better. There's more over here. Take that, you little buggers.
Come on out, officer. I'm sorry, Paul. I liked you. Now you gotta die. Mark it down. Ah, poor Floyd. Thanks for your glasses, buddy. I appreciate that. Anything I need? I probably need these for something. Right? Poor Paul. side of his eyes open.
I told you, I don't know anything.
Be reasonable. Officer Mack may enjoy this, but I don't. Just tell us where to find your friend so we can talk to him.
He's my friend. I was worried about him. What does he have to do with any of this anyway?
Probably nothing.
Uh-oh.
Which is why you need to tell me where he is, so I can talk to him. Go ahead, officer.
You better talk, girlie.
No, please don't!
That's enough.
You officer. Asshole.
Be reasonable, Amata. Officer Mack may enjoy it.
Hey, Freddy!
Tell him where to find you.
I knew you had half a brain, or half a mind. Now you have none.
He's here. Don't let him get away.
Don't do anything. You stay put right there, mister. Otherwise, I am not going to be afraid to shoot your brains out.
God, help.
Logically, he can just attack from behind. But considering Amata likes you too much, she would not appreciate that. Let's see. Nothing important. I'll just leave you be. Amata, hey, you alright? Jonas. His name was Jonas, man. Look at that.
Hold on, Jonas. I need to record this first. I don't really know how to tell you this. I hope you'll understand, but I know you might be angry. I thought about it for a long time, but in the end, I decided it was best for you not to know. So many things could have gone wrong, and there's really no telling how the Overseer will react when he finds out. It's best if he can blame everything on me. Obviously, you already know that I'm gone. It was something I needed to do. You're an adult now. You're ready to be on your own. Maybe someday things will change and we can see each other again. I can't tell you why I left or where I'm going. I don't want you to follow me. God knows life in the vault isn't perfect, but at least you'll be safe. Just knowing that will be enough to keep me going.
Don't mean to rush you, Doc, but I'd feel better if we got this over with.
Okay, go ahead. Goodbye. I love you.
I didn't know anything. This one happened. I mean, who could have ever predicted that the whole vault goes crazy when you leave? Hey, Amata, you okay?
Thank you! I told you my father wasn't himself. I don't know what he might have done if you hadn't come along. You'd better get out of here. I'll try to meet you at the vault door. If I don't make it, good luck.
Shit, man. Fuck you. I need that. I only took the bobby pins, not the clothes. Office key. Pistol ammo. This will have to do. All right. Lentons. I'll come back with the password if I can't hack it. Okay, this should be simple. Let's see here. All right, four attempts. Now, the way these puzzles work is you have to pick one of the words and then try to use what letters are in your incorrect guess to make it a correct guess. However, with Fallout 3, it reset every time you exit it. So normally the best idea would be try three times and then exit and then start again. Swiss is your password. Shoot. Okay. So find words that look like Swiss with two letters. No. Let's see. Probably tries.
Haha! I'm smart.
I am the best hacker in the world. Let's see what the dossiers have on everybody. Tunnel snakes. If Butch and his lover collect the link wings across the mountain one more time, they'll have more to deal with than their... Oh. Then the teacher, their services have come in handy upon occasion, I must admit. But they're becoming unruly. If dogs become feral, they must be put down. I have to remind Butch of that upon our next meeting. Beatrice. Just what Vault 101 needs. An absent mind, sexually repressed psychophant? Beatrice has served Vault 101 avidly for years, but her mind is growing feeble. I'll have to speak with her, with our good doctors, about some kind of long-term pharmaceutical solution. We may at least be able to keep her comfortable and quiet until she passes on. Jonas. I never should have assigned Jonas as James' assistant. He was always too idealistic for his own good. Now he's in a separate meeting with the good doctor, who gleefully feels his ears with even more idealistic nonsense. I've considered reassigning him, but the truth is Jonas is a fine medic in his own right, and hiding him down in maintenance would be a terrible waste of resources. Amada. Every time I'm trying to get Amada to open up, she just pushes me further and further away. Since she was a child, I've tried to instill her to those virtues that made this vault what it is today. Loyalty, honesty, commitment, hard work. She does try with a lot of guidance and has grown into a very fine young woman. That makes it a bit sadder that she continues to alienate me. She looks at me and sees the overseer, not the father, that she has cared for all her alone, since she was an infant. What did you do with her mother then, Einstein? Service. Scouting reports. Our test suggests the intimate vicinity of Vault is no longer dangerously irradiated, although the background radiation is still well above safe levels. Pockets of more intense radiation appear to still be common, and all surface water seems to be undrinkable. We need to carry ample supplies of radics with us for on future surveys, but hazard suits do not seem to be necessary for general exploration. Our old maps are largely useless. The town of Springfield is in an abandoned ruin. Springvale. Now pre-war roads have disappeared and are no longer passable. We have encountered a group of a monstrous ant which appeared to confirm Hecky's series of mutation due to the extended exposure of radiation. We drove off the ants with gunfire and collected several specimens for study. On return to the vault, see Exhibit A. Okay. The good news is that human civilization still survives despite everything. We discovered something known as Megaton. Exhibit B. The inhabitants, although somewhat wary at first, soon welcomed us into the town. We spent a good deal of time in Megaton and learned a great deal about the capital wasteland from Megaton is a fortified outpost of civilization. But since the giant ants are the least of the dangers in the new world, we agreed that it was prudent to return to the vault immediately to revise our survey plans. In light of what we've learned, Lewis and Agnes remain in Megaton to serve as ambassadors and continue the information until we return. Miss Palmer. Interesting. Exhibit A. Shoot. That's a dangerous creature. That's Megaton. That's probably the best place to go. I'll take instructions. Letter for Braun. If you're reading this, emergency vault internal procedures have been instant, and you and your control group have been sealed into your vault. Congratulations! We're now viable part of the most ambitious program ever undertaken by Vault Tech. If you have not yet read your sealed orders, do so now. There will be outlined experiment protocols designed to your control group. Please remember, deviation from these protocols in any way will jeopardize the success of the program and may be considered grounds for termination by Vault Tech Corporation. Your vault may or may not have been selected to receive a GEC module. Please see attachment for more details. But one will not receive a GEC module and should operate under the guidelines laid forth in the overseer's sealed orders. The GEC is quite simply the most advanced piece of technology ever developed by Vault Tech, a terraforming module capable of creating life and complete lifelessness. After riding out a stone nuclear Armageddon in Vault Tech Hardened Vault, residents can activate the GEC, create a new Earth and paradise. Craters of dust will give way to rolling gristlings and sparkling clear water. Of course, due to the time and monetary constraints, not every vault will be equipped with a GEC module. Okay. Let's get out of here. I got all I needed. Lewis and Agnes, huh? They secretly work for Vault 101. Let's get the hell out of here. I have plenty of ammo, roaches. I ain't afraid of any of you. Of any of you. Okay, we made it. Okay, let's get out of here. Aha! I got the door open.
Actually opened it. You did it! You opened the door! My God, I almost didn't believe it was possible. No.
I don't know about you. You gave me the pistol.
If anyone can survive out there, it's you.
Well, you want to come with?
It's tempting, but my place is here. The vault needs me more than you do. I'm the only one who has a chance to talk some sense into my father. Listen.
All right, you do that.
If you do catch up with your dad, tell him I'm sorry for... for, you know, Jonas and my father and everything. Goodbye.
No.
Stop! In the name of the Overseer!
Would you just fuck off, sir?
Shouldn't have tried to run.
I shouldn't have tried to run. You shouldn't have messed with me. Fucking assholes. Hopefully Amada gets out safe. Okay, so I think I got everything I need. Yeah, I think I'll be good. I got a pistol with plenty of ammo, and we're just gonna go to Megaton.
You've got to get out of here. Someone's sure to come see what's going on. Take care.
Bye, Amada. As I put on my hat. Do I need glasses? It would probably look stupid. But I'm probably gonna need some armor. That's better. Out we go. God, that's bright. Up. Here we are, folks. So Megaton is over there. Of course I know all this, but that's where we gotta head. Level up! Move this up 5. And since I'm using the small guns, might as well. Lady Killer in combat, you do 10% damage against female opponents. Outside of combat, you'll sometimes have access to unique dialogue. Okay. Well, let's get to Megaton, I suppose. DC, huh? You never know what to expect. Apparently people get mailed frag grenades. Springvale. This was the town they were talking about that got abandoned.
And you're listening to Enclave Radio. The voice of warmth and reason in this cold.
Yeah, about that. Screw you. Soda machine. You know. Looks like that. Dumpsters. Remember, rule of scalvage. Rule of scalvaging. I Let's just keep getting towards Megaton. It says it's over here. That's a cow. It's a Brahmin. Huh. Hello there. Well, Vance.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome, welcome. My name is Crow, and I travel the land offering vestments of protection. And you are fortunate I found you in time. You bear
Yay.
The look of one who is haunted. But I am proud to say that my wares can protect you from even the cruel claws of death itself. Have a look.
Well, I may need more than a pistol.
Have a look. See if anything calls out to you.
You can have that. And have a baton. Have both my batons, actually. And some glasses. Do I need any more clothes? Not really. I can take those stem packs off your hands. And trade you for some psycho. Now I'm low on money, so I'm gonna take your money and give you the pre-war money. And a wrench. And a sensor module and a conduit.
A pleasure doing business
cash.
With you.
Thank you. The bomb is perfectly safe, you promise. Since we're in a safe city. Home sweet Megaton, I suppose.
I'll be dead.
Hello there.
Newcomer. Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too, when the need arises. I don't know why, but
Hi.
I like you, boy. Something tells me you're all right. So welcome to Megaton. Just holler if you need something.
I forgot how much I like you.
Friendly and well-mannered. I think we're gonna get along just fine. You treat my
Lucas
people
Sims,
nice,
definitely
and you're
one
welcome
of the best
to stay
NPCs
as long as you'd like.
That you first meet, for sure.
I'm
glad proceed.
We understand each other. Now,
I'm looking for my dad.
Nope. Sorry. I got enough fires to put out in this place that I don't have time to keep tabs on every visitor. I'd ask around town.
Sure. I could probably.
I don't trust any of the locals to. And hell, Cromwell and those crazies from the Church of Adam, they worship the damn thing. Why? Do you think you got the know-how?
I can see about disarming.
Oh, all right. If you get the job done.
I don't need a reward.
Well, that's mighty decent of you. Just don't.
Plus 100 cash for.
Go blowing us up.
A bomb.
All right.
Now that I'm helping you.
Well,
can you
come to think
look
of
my
it,
dad?
I do remember a stranger coming through here. Had a look in his eye. You know the kind a man gets when he's got a purpose. Spent some time up in the saloon. Might want to check with Moriarty. Just watch yourself. That man's trouble.
Okay.
It's called the Wasteland for a reason. But there are settlements, too, spread all around. The human race is stubborn like that. To the south, you've got Rivet City. But don't bother going to D.C. The place is a war zone.
Shoot.
Don't fool around with that bomb.
Let's take a look at this bomb. And see if we can just disarm this thing for good. Explosives 25 or higher. Okay, so we can disarm that bomb very easily.
Now, I know I've never seen you in Megaton before. We get people trying to settle down here all the time. Anyway, if you're hungry, you came to the right place. What can I get?
Come forth to gather and behold the power of Atrium.
Ah, look at this!
What's up, you?
New blood! Tell me, boy, you ever hear... Now, I don't know you from Adam, but I got you pegged for a patriot, and any patriot worth his salt is gonna toss his gun in for the Enclave. Any day now, they're gonna roll up here, and then this nightmare will be over for good. But listen to me, Ramble. I'm Nathan. What can I do for you? I couldn't
What's
tell you, really.
Down?
I talked to Manya, if you care that much. She's lived in Megaton longer than anyone.
Okay.
God bless the Enclave.
Sure. Strange old man, patriotic. Much like some voters from last year, from the last presidential election, I suppose. What's this now? Oh, it's a house I'm not allowed into. You know, just a supply store we can check out real quick. Ah, right here. Alley-oop. Hi.
Hey, I hear you're that stray from the vault. Oh, I haven't seen one of you for years. Good to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Craterside Supply. But what I really do is mostly tinkering and research. Say,
okay.
I'm working on a book about the waste.
Sure.
Great. Just tell me what it's like to live underground.
It was paradise down there. No fear, no worries. No fighting? Till my dad left.
A runaway dad, huh? I've seen plenty of them before, but none with the big 101 on their back. Good luck finding him. Maybe the armored vault suit will help you out there, huh?
That'll I'll gladly take that.
In fact...
Sure.
Well, it's a dangerous place out there in the wastes, right? People could really use a compilation of good advice, like a waste... For that, I need an assistant to test my theories. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's... No, then they just yell a lot at me with mean, mean words.
Sorry, Moira. I'll help.
Good enthusiasm! Now, I think the first chapter will have to be about surviving day-to-day dangers. Things like where it is and isn't safe to find food, the dangers of radiation, and how to avoid and even profit from dangerous landmines. Ooh.
Getting food.
Well, food and medicine. Everyone needs them once in a while, right? There's an old super-duper mart not far from here. I need to... Oh, great!
Okay.
Food is most important, but see... What do you need?
Well, what can I sell? Have some glasses. Have this helmet. I don't do drugs. Leather armor wouldn't be too bad, but... Well,
good hunting!
So let's just do this part of the side quest, I suppose. That's not too bad. It'll get us a level up so that we can disarm that bomb. Excuse me. Neato. Man, I wonder if all 76 is going to be compared to this. Hi. Excuse me, Mr. Sims. I'm going for a quick run to a Super Duper Mart. Do we need to should I pick you up anything before I go? I don't think he wanted anything. Just saying.
Welcome.
Well, we got along. Be quiet. You weren't here.
Please stand clear of the gate.
What do you want?
Please, do you have any water?
Have this.
Are you serious? I can't offer anything in exchange, you know. I can just have it? For free?
Water. It's the least I can do.
Oh, precious water. Thank you. You're a saint.
Yay! Am I a boondock saint? Probably not, considering most people don't know who the boondock saints are. Okay, so the plan is, go to Super Duper Mart, do that side quest, and that should give us enough to level up our explosives so that we can disarm the bomb and call it a stream. That'll be the main goal, disarming a bomb. What's over here? Oh, it's a float fly? Did you just... Bye! Enjoy death. Mart's right there. There's a silo over here. I wonder if there's anything that's been in the house. Or a supplies camp. Fundamental boxes. Scrap metal. I suppose that's worth something. Books. Chinese Army Special Ops Training Manual, huh? Sneak increased by one. Yay.
Oh.
Okay, what shot me? Oh, it's a giant. Oh. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Ammo box. More pistol bullets? Don't mind if I do. The Yamada pistol. That's what I always call the first pistol you get out of the vault. Serves you well. Wonder what killed these cows. Or these Brahma, I should say. See what we got in here. Chinese radio beacon. Over here. Let's go see what's over on the other side of the store. Whatever it is, the iBot's attacking him as well. Oh, there goes the iBot. Never stood a chance against him. Raiders. Well, they saw me. Oh. Don't engage.
To your heart. Old minds are like old horses.
I found another iBot.
You must exercise them if you wish to keep them in working order.
A 32 caliber pistol. No, thank you. Ooh, Barca. It's another dead raider. I'll take your pistol ammo. Ooh, a knife! Mine! Alrighty, let's see what happened. I thought I saw one up here. So he probably got shot off. No, he probably died on top of the bus. See a corpse. Well, worst case scenario. Have a quick bite, have a quick drink. Time to go inside and raid the mart. Into the super duper mart we go. Okay. So, let's go find everything that we need. Was over here. Mine, energy cell, and a pistol. Lockpicking, same as in Skyrim. Shut up, bottles. Ah, great. That person might see me. There you go. Food storage. All are mine. Cart. Now, if I remember correctly, if we get back to the back of the store, we'll find that medicine.
I'm gonna tear you up. Yeah, tear him up.
You weren't supposed to see me, asshole. Well, time to have a drink of dirty water. The store. Okay. Yeah. I think I can hit this person. Nice! Got him! Gun practice makes perfect. Now, bullets I'll take. Like a hockey mask, I suppose. Another mine. Yes, thank you. Pharmacy key. I'll take that for sure. Pork and beans. Delicious. Oh yeah, man. I'll take your weapon for sure. An assault rifle. Well, that's an upgrade. And I have a book to read. Quality of the rifle's not the best, but I can probably find someone to repair it for me. More pistol rounds. I have a key. I'm still gonna hack the terminal. Warrior! No. Dancing? I'm close to dancing. ING. Wanting. Hanging? No. Gaming? Now for the reset feature, that's pretty nifty. Physics? Nope. Massive? No. Camping? No. Come on, Sean. Show you're a better hacker than Sombra. First try. Very close, actually. I was one letter off. Let's see what we can find back here. Mini nukes. Grenades. That's why not. Office employee ID, I'll take that. Some bullets. All the pharmacy supplies. Coca-Cola Quantum, eh? Regular Coca-Cola. I wish this drink existed in real life. You know? I would literally love a drink of actual Nuka-Cola. And that's all the supplies I'm gonna get. More assault rifle ammo. Time to hack. Is the password bonds? No. Let's see here. Let's see, I can do this. Is the password Gibbs? No. Tires. Lives. Fries. Flock? Balls. Dash. Close. Storm? Nope. It's trade. No. Greed. No. Creed. No, not Creed. Ride. How difficult is one password, apparently? Cards! No. Hatch. Got it! Front maintenance routine.
Loading personality.
The robot.
Robco. R04V9. Office helper.
What's up?
Running default office protocol. Air or loading daily agenda. Air or
right.
Security breach detected. Please stand back.
Something right here.
Move along, please.
Well, now we got more raiders coming in. I wonder if the pistol would be more accurate. I missed. How did none of that hit her? I don't know. Target down. Wait, I have an idea. Frag out. I got one for you too. Oh, and another sorry. Oh, you are so kind. I need one. That's all of them. How did you not notice any commotion? Well, you deserve that. To be honest.
Greetings, fellow office employee.
Uh-oh.
Please present your valid ID.
Here?
Scanning for office ID. Oh. Hostile target detected.
You leave my robot alone, pal. Okay. Well, now we got that done. And we got a cool new weapon. Probably something I'm going to go to a lot, this assault rifle. And we got the food, and we got the medicine, and we're going to have a great day. And now we can fast travel. Katie Skywalker sounds like someone fun to raid, huh? Well, let's go finish up for today and just
you
give her a friendly raid.
Stranger?
Hello.
Check out crater
side. And then we're gonna go to fucking bed. Lay in a nap.
Hello, sweet child. Remembers.
Hello, sweet child. With the assault rifle and the pink mohawk who looks like they could kill me in one good foul look. I am by far the most unique looking. Alright, let's head back and get our reward.
Is that yours?
And press that. I meant to go in here though.
So, how's this game? Really? You
there
did?
There you go. It's very hard to talk about my way past that many people shooting me.
Oh, dear. Well, I guess the dangers around those old supplies keeps it from being smooth sailing. Otherwise, well, keep
right.
What you got. Just traded for a big food shipment myself. Here, take a bit. My treat. The taste kind of grates after a while.
What?
And take this. It's an old food sanitizer. Just carry it with you, and it should automatically make most food and drink more, better.
Radiation's
well,
easy, I suppose.
So I need you to get a bit.
Okay.
Oh, you're a peach. Now, 200 rad should just.
Ah, oh, boy. Severe radiation poisoning. Oh boy! Easier said than done.
Ah!
Ow! What's the best way to get rads?
Give your bodies to Adam, my friend.
Stand next to this fucking mob and keep drinking the water.
His glow and be divided. There shall be no tears, no sorrows, no suffering. For in the division, we shall see our release from the pain and hardships of this world. Yea, your suffering shall exist no longer. It shall be washed
away. So that's
200. Adam's glow.
We're gonna keep doing this, unfortunately, oh boy.
Each of us shall give birth to a billion stars formed from the mass of our wretched and filthy
bodies.
Each of us. Shall be mother and father.
This is by far the fastest way to get these optional objectives done, and you get some pretty cool rewards.
Shall know an end to pain, and shall know
400 rads.
I urge you, my friend, come drink with me.
1,000 rad equals you die, pretty much.
Glorious Atom,
Can we just get our 600 leave and then Uncle get cured and Uncle be a happy little camper?
This frail body. I beg.
I could probably eat something there.
Of you to use me as your vessel. Guide me to your brilliance.
There we go.
Divide each particle and give me.
I'm simply glowing. Now you better keep your door open, lady.
If you need
what?
To buy something, we're up in Craterside Supply can help you. Watch out.
She's different. Yeah, so's the rest of the world.
Oh, feeling it.
I'm about as ready as I can get without burning a hole in the floor.
I can tell! You're positively glowing! Now,
that's my line! I'm fine. Never better.
Oh, you poor dear. Putting on a brave face like that. Well, don't worry. It'll all be better. And it's for a good cause. Now,
yeah.
Let me take a few notes, and I'll handle that nasty radiation with a bit of my own homemade rad cure concoction. I've never had a chance to test it out on someone so heavily dosed. Oh, but I'm sure it'll work out fine. Exciting, isn't it?
No.
Okay, a little Brahmin milk, a couple magnets, and maybe a few happy
Don't
thoughts.
Don't try anything.
And I'm dead.
Well, you're alive. Oh, that's the good news. But there was a little side effect. A teeny tiny, mutation. But it seems to be benign, at least. Here, take a few radiation chems, as my little way of saying, I'm sorry I twisted your DNA like a kitten with a ball of yarn.
Hooray! Moira's original experiment had an excellent side effect. Now, when you suffer from advanced radiation poisoning, crippled limbs automatically regenerate. Oh, great! I'm the Hulk! So go to minefield.
You should probably
try not
leave
to die.
Now.
I am leaving. Ah, my days. Oh crap. So we'll disarm the bomb tomorrow. I'm just gonna raid someone to call out a stream. I mean, Fireball's watching this person. They're close to 100 followers, so maybe we can get them up to 100. Why not? And of course, my audience leaves whenever I raid someone.